aliens and adventurers. Yes, it's well worth the feat.
Watching them come out here as we were doing backstage, which is this. If you were given the choice of taking one of these cars home after the show and keeping it, which one would it be?
Aventador!
Lots of noise and pointing at this one.
Aston. Yeah, there's a lot of Aston.
Yeah. Yeah, no,
there's a few Lamborghinis going on as well.
Tell you what, James Mason's standing next to me. Which one would you choose?
Oh! One to take home and keep, is it? Right.
Yeah.
Well, that is quite tricky because there isn't anything here I don't like. Let's be honest. But actually, what am I talking about? Over here, there is a car I absolutely adore. In fact, I've ordered one. It is the Ferrari 458 Speciale. It's fantastic, yes. It is fantastic. And the thing is, Ferrari will claim that this isn't just a special version of the 458. They actually describe it as a different driving concept because, on the whole, they talk prancing horseshit about their own cars. But they do have a point to a certain extent because it has more power, it has a higher rev limit, it's got bigger brakes, it has a lighter body, it's got active aerodynamics all over it. It's got an interior that's stripped out, it's not leather and all that stuff, it's Alcantara, it's sort of halfway to being a racing car almost. And the effect of this is, it is a bit like driving a 458, but in which everything has been sort of sharpened up. You know when you buy a new Tenere and there's four HD ones and everything is suddenly clearer and your life is improved? That's exactly what it feels like. It tickles your fizz gland in a way that I don't think any other car does.
James, it's almost as though they designed it with you in mind, isn't it?
Yeah, they did. They have a big picture of me on the wall.
Do
they?
Yes.
You can see that looking at it. It is like looking at James May with wheels.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah.
No,
I agree. It's an amazing car. Yeah. Amazing.
And you've ordered one of them.
I have, yes. It comes in a few weeks.
Is it?
Yes.
Does it come with this stripe, James?
Actually, no. The stripe is an option. You don't have to have a stripe. It's one of the few options on the car.
Oh, right. Have you ordered a stripe on yours?
Yeah, yeah, of course I have. Of course, you can't have that and not have the stripe on.
Yeah,
look at it.
Where are you going with this?
You're about to find out. James, how much was the stripe on your Ferrari?
How much?
Yes, how much did you have to pay to have a stripe on your new car?
Oh, $1,200. $12,000.
$12,000?
Yeah.
£6,000.
I know.
It's just paint.
Yeah, but it's Ferrari paint. It's just very
James,
what? Do you know what you're going to need really soon?
Go on.
Critics have said, no, it should have an old-fashioned manual gearbox rather than a PDK double clutch system. But that's exactly what it would feel in this car, old-fashioned, because this is a masterpiece. It's my choice.
That's your choice?
Yes.
And the car you already own back in England is a...
Oh, shit.
You've done exactly the same as him.
Yeah, it's one of these.
You've chosen the car you've already got. Well, of course, I'm more wise than you.
Are you?
Oh, yeah. Now, I've got always... It is tricky, because I get every single one of them pretty much I like. SLS, a car I adore, that's the most sideways, and it suits me very much. Lamborghini is the fastest and the most Lamborghini-ish, the Aventador, obviously, and that is a brilliant car.
Yeah.
It makes the blue come out of the back, and I love that. But weirdly, the car I would choose to take home and keep out of all of these is the little Alfa.
Is it?
Oh, boy.
Come on, then, make your case for it.
It has got a few problems, I admit. No power steering, so the steering's very heavy. It follows the camber appallingly on the road, particularly on these big wheels. The steering wheel would be rejected by the makers of a Dodgem car for being too cheap a plastic. The interior is as well appointed as an Afghan's cave. The noise is catastrophic. If you do more than 5 minutes at 100 kilometres an hour, your ears will be bleeding. The chassis is a carbon fibre top. So you'd like a Formula One car or a McLaren P1, so you'd imagine the handling would be very good. It isn't. The petrol tank is about the size of a Zippo, so you have to stop every 5 minutes to fill it up, and you can't get out. It's impossible. Even you cannot get out of that without doing the hands and knees thing, which looks a bit stupid. However, the thing is, we all have friends, and all of our friends have got faults. They late, or they smell, or they scratch their arse, or whatever it might be. And that's what makes them human. All the other cars here, they've all got perfect engines, perfect refinement, perfect gearboxes. They feel like laptops. They feel like machines. The Alfa, because it's riddled with faults, actually feels human. And that is why I absolutely adore this thing. Really, genuinely do. I'm actually thinking of buying one.
Are you?
Yes.
Is that why you've just bought a Golf GTR?
Which you have.
I have just done that. I've done that because I am, what's the word? I know, unemployed. So I've got a job, but if I get a job, I want an Alfa. And that's it. It was now waved goodbye to the Supercar. Yeah, we talked about the F12.
No, that is not short on power.
No, it's very, very, very powerful. Yeah. It's too powerful, I think.
Yeah.
The Aston still looks very, very good, even today.
It's getting
that's awesome. Awesome. Yeah,
that's it's right. Really awesome. Bentley Continental. Yeah. That would be very good at herding cattle.
No, obviously.
Didn't do that in a Bentley.
Except for legal reasons, we never have.
No.
And then, of course, the California team there, the first turbocharged Ferrari, Since the F4, yeah, yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So there they go, bye-bye Supercars.
Bye-bye Supercars indeed, that is a fantastic collection. Actually, there is one, if you don't mind, I'd like to keep one of them back for a short while. It's a car for which I hope there will be a certain amount of love in the audience, because there is from us. It's the Nissan GT-R. What do we think? And I just want to keep this back because it's going to be used in the next round of our Crashes tournament.
History.